Out that you can sing.
No, we need money first.
I'm bald.
Oh, we're all bald.
Don't tell anyone, please.
I'm dumb too.
Did you want to get a haircut at all?
No.
Nope.
No. I had one yesterday.
Brian Epstein had booked the group into the Plaza Hotel under their individual names. The hotel management was horrified to learn that these four English businessmen were the Beatles, something that thousands of screaming teenagers outside already knew. It was history repeating itself. The Beatles drew large emotional crowds, charmed the New York press, and as in London, 4 months earlier, appeared on a national television broadcast that brought them into nearly every living room in the country.
Now, yesterday and today, our theater's been jammed with newspapermen and hundreds of photographers from all over the nation, and these veterans agree with me that the city never has witnessed the excitement stirred by these youngsters from Liverpool who call themselves the Beatles. Now, tonight, you're going to twice be entertained by them. Right now, and again in the second half of our show, ladies and gentlemen, the Beatles!
Close your eyes and I'll kiss you. Tomorrow I'll miss you. Remember, I'll always be true. And then while I'm away, I'll write home every day and I'll send all my loving to you.
Following the Ed Sullivan Show, they traveled to Washington for their first live concert appearance in America. Awaiting them was a scene to which they would soon become accustomed.
We'd like to thank everybody for buying this particular record and starting this thing off in America and giving us the chance to come here and see you all in Washington. Thank you!
I've gone to see most of the groups and I met them all. And now I've really met the Beatles and now my life is complete.
Say to me, you
Thank you very much, everybody. And good evening.
For all their accomplishments in Britain, the Beatles have now entered a whole new dimension of success. The American music industry had never witnessed such a spectacular rise. By April the 4th, 1964, they held the top 5 places on the American charts. 1 week later, 14 of the top 100 singles were Beatles songs.
Was America something like what you thought it would be like?
No, nothing like it. We thought it'd be much quieter. We thought it, you know, we'd have to grow on everybody, and everybody seems to sort of know us all, you know, as if we've been here for years. It's great.
Abrams,
speed!
20,
take one.
Action!
It's been a hard day's night. The Beatles returned to England to start work on their first feature film, A Hard Day's Night. The movie, directed by American Richard Lester, showed the Beatles being their own witty, charming selves and featured 7 new Lennon-McCartney songs.
Tell me, how did you find America?
Turn left to Greenland.
Has success changed your life?
Yes.
I'd like to keep Britain tidy.
Are you a mod or a rocker?
No, I'm a mocker.
In June, they made their first world tour, playing Scandinavia, Holland, the Far East, and Australia. Ringo had tonsillitis and missed 3/4 of the tour. In his place sat a session drummer, Jimmy Nicol. A 22,000-mile tour of North America followed in August. In only 6 months, the Beatles had played over 50 cities on 4 continents. British LP, Beatles for Sale, showed that Beatlemania was taking its toll. The music inside was also more serious. There was the pessimism of Babies in Black and the Dylan-influenced I'm a Loser. In all, the eight original songs were somewhat morose, especially when set in juxtaposition to the glad spirits of A Hard Day's Night. But the Beatles were still showing remarkable artistic growth. John and Paul's songs continued to break pop music precedent. The melodies were more inventive, the arrangements more complex, and their individual composing styles began to emerge.
The obvious cliche one is that John was a word person and Paul was a music person. But that's too simple to be true. Paul could write some great lyrics and John could write some great music. They started out by writing songs together, but it didn't last too long. They generally wrote their own songs and then would play the one to the other. The other might suggest a little bit of a change in the middle, and that was the extent of their collaboration. But it was very much a competition, and a very healthy one too. Whoever had composed the song would sing it to me, generally with an acoustic guitar. I would sit myself on a stool in the studio and they would stand in front of me and just sing away. And then we would work out what to do, right? Okay, let's decide how we're going to do the introduction. Shall we have a change of key? What instrument should we bring in? Although I was always wanting to have new sounds and new ideas coming through, and I found that they were almost more inquisitive than I was. In fact, in the end, it kind of exhausted me. They were saying, what new sounds can we have? What new instruments can we have? What can you do to my voice to make it different?
Do you want to hear any of it before you do it?
Sometimes they knew what they wanted to do, but more often than not, they didn't.
Say you will love me if I have to go.
It was a complete experimental place to work in, which was great.
Somehow I will know. Someday when I'm lonely, wishing you weren't so far away, then I will remember things we said today. You say you'll be mine, girl, till the end of time.
Things seem to be easier with them than with other people that I work with. But in finding the right means of expression or the right tempo for a song, the right style for it, seemed to come more naturally to them than with other people.
Jumping the gun somewhat, Capitol issued the Beatles' next single as being from their new film, Eight Arms to Hold You. Before the film came out, that title was changed to...
Help, I need somebody.
Help,
not just anybody.
Help,
you know I need someone.
Help!
When I was younger, so much younger than today,
I never
needed anybody's help in any way.
It was the Help soundtrack album, however, that brought the first big departure from their proven formula. A song whose working title had been Scrambled Eggs.
When Paul sang it to me, first of all, I said, you know,